Yeah, foo. This is beef frissoles from Woolies. Fry pan heating up. And over here, I'm chopping onions. Now, how you stop onions from getting, tears in your eyes, is see this bit here. Notice I haven't cut it off. I've cut it down the middle when I cut the thing so I can get the peel off. But if you don't cut that bit off, you don't get the, it doesn't bleed. Once you cut that off, it bleeds, and that's what gets in your eyes and stings, right? So don't do it. Yeah, foo. That's the onion dice, see? That's the last chop I made, like as I went doot, 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 doot. That's why I don't have sore eyes right now. Not crying. So that's there. Olive oil. I've just got to open the lid. Don't worry. Yeah, nah, shit, I know it's gone dark. Oh, God. No. Olive oil. Onion. Kitchen tool. Right. Oh yeah, come on. Oh yeah, let that caramelize. Woo! Then we'll put these bastards in. Actually, you know what? We'll put them in at the same time. There we go. Cook, my little pretties. We're gonna do eins. Counting like Arnold Schwarzenegger or David Hasselhoff. Dry. No, hang on. Eins. Dry. Eins, zwei, sorry. Eins, zwei. So eins is one, zwei is two. Dry has three. And wir is four. Funk is five, but we're only doing wir. Why am I saying it in German? I don't know. Maybe I think it's because I watched Arnold Schwarzenegger in the box last night. Alrighty, this is how it's looking at the moment. Good lookins. Flip the onions a little bit, and I chop them up into little bite-sized pieces. I don't know why, and I've already flipped them a bit. You see some of it's a bit brown. And we'll keep cooking. Yee! Oh, yeah. So I'm mixing it all around together just to make sure onion and meat juice gets all over the pan, because that's what's going to make that taste good. Alrighty, once you make it in the pan of the juices, that's when it tastes great. Right, I'm going to get this all out for Neil. Just for Neil. Come on. All right, then, so that's in there. Now I'm going to put a bit of water in. Slowly, you gradually add water. Yeah, it might be a bit too much to add. You got to do it slowly, slowly, slowly. Okay, needs more meal. I don't have it on a high temp. It's on a more of a lower temperature now. They may call it a simmer, I don't know. Okay, I haven't done this tremendously well. There's a lot of lumps. But we'll keep going. Hopefully we'll get them out. Anyway, you get the gist, I'll be doing this. I reckon that's pretty good. Get in there, go on. Took a number of minutes to get the gravy right. I kept having to add water and wait for it to thicken again, and slowly add water and wait to thicken again, because it was very salty. And it was very strong, and then it just tasting, and it broke down a little bit with more water, the saltiness and whatever, and it sort of got, still kept getting thick with the heat and whatever's in that grey box, the thickening agent. And yeah, you can see it's a nice glisten to the gravy now, everything, and it's, I think it's got a pretty good taste. Hang on, I'll have a bit of a taste of it now. With a bit of this stuff, a bit of the meat and onion nut in it. Rissole, all right, let's see. Oh, yeah. That's really delicious. You know what's missing, though? That'd be beautiful with some mushrooms through it, too. Yum-ho. Anyway, I'm going to eat this. Yeah, so this would go great with some mashed potato, any potato, really, and some greens and whatever. I think it really would have been nice with some mushies through it. It's actually very tasty. I'm just going to have it with... there's some sort of I like this rice, this packaged saffron rice in the Woolworths salads section, and it's got sultanas and things through it as well. It's a yummy rice, so I'm going to have some of that rice dish after I've eaten this meat dish. I just cracked my favourite pepper all over it, and that made a big difference. It's really tasty.